What is going to happen on May 8th in Washington, D.C.?
It's a very comprehensive program. It kind of reflects the last 100 years in the musical life of Armenia, which is, you know, obviously very closely linked to the genocide history. Of course, the basis of the whole thing is Gomidas. I mean, he is the infrastructure mm-hmm. of the entire Armenian musical culture. Mm-hmm. And everything comes from Gomidas. Without Gomidas, it would have been a completely different story. We would have had musical composers and this and that. But the quality, the profile of the music would have been quite different. We have two entities coming from Armenia. One is the Armenian Philharmonic Orchestra with Topchian conducting, and they are doing a wonderful selection of pieces. They are doing Mansurian's Requiem, which was written in memory of the Armenian victims of the genocide. It was premiered in Berlin in 2006, and the orchestra will be doing, the orchestra and the choir together, uh-huh. they will be doing certain selections from the Requiem. Interestingly enough, the Requiem is using the Latin words, Agnus Dei and all of that, but the structure, the melodic structure, is an Armenian Badarak. So it's a very interesting juxtaposition or superimposition, whatever you want. I'm looking forward to it. Then they are doing, as actually Hasmik Papyan is doing, Babajanian's Vocalese, which is a meltingly beautiful piece for orchestra and voice. Vocalese, of course, is a kind of music that does not have text. It is just a vowel that a singer's choosing is utilized. Rachmaninoff has a very famous vocalese. And then next to it, Hasmik will be doing Kananchian's Orov, which is a very famous song, obviously. Then they are doing St. Vartan's Symphony of Alan Hovhannes, which was written for the 1500th anniversary of the Vartanans Paderazm in 451. And again, that's a very long, 45-minute long piece. It has 24 movements, but they are doing only portions of it. Mm-hmm. It's really a masterpiece of that period. No, 1952, I think it is. It was actually premiered in Carnegie Hall by the New York Philharmonic. That's quite a thing. And then the program will end with Aram Khachaturian's Spartacus ballet. A couple of scenes from the ballet. I know the adagio will be there and maybe the dance. I think it's from the second suite of the Spartacus. Now, I'm kind of doing this backwards, going back to the first movement. The other group that is coming from Armenia is the Hover Choir, and Sona is the conductor of Hover Choir, and they are doing exclusively Gomidas pieces, and I think that's very appropriate. I think Gomidas writes wonderfully for choir. Before then, the concert will open with Onik Dinkcian singing Lele Yaman, I'm sorry. After the choir, I and Ayda Kavafyan and Narek Harutyunyan together will be doing Khachaturian's clarinet trio, mm-hmm. the first two movements only. Khachaturian had written this as a student at Moscow Conservatory, and Prokofiev was so impressed with this work that he had introduced it in Paris. That was the first time that Khachaturian was being heard outside of the Soviet Union. This was in 1936. And then Levon Chilingirian, Alexander Chavushian, and I will be doing the last movement of Babajanian's trio. Again, this trio is a very important composition in Babajanian's lifespan. That was written much later, in 52, 53, something like that. Then Isabel Bayraktarian will appear, doing five Gomida songs, and these are arranged by her husband, Serge Krajian, for two violins, viola, cello, piano, and I'm sure she will do a wonderful, wonderful job. She's a terrific singer. So that's the program. At the end of the very end of the program, all of us will be on stage and will be singing Girigay.